Well, this week I took you to the mountains of Mexico, where monarch butterflies who came all the way from places like Canada and Minnesota spend their winters. There's so much more science behind their biology and migration, so we have some extra stories and links online. We're showing you some of them this morning. Milkweed is vital to the monarch's life cycle. It's the sole source of food for the caterpillars, and not surprisingly, they follow the plants.
When the days are getting warmer, they will mate, and they will fly back to find the milkweed in Texas and Louisiana. They don't eat much. They are just stretching their wings, and they're moving little by little inside the reserve to find a cool spot. They need to save energy, because in February they will start mating, and after mating, they still need to go back to find the milkweed. So they need to save energy. Every year, actually, they are moving a little bit earlier.
Is that a climate change?
Probably a climate change effect. So if the milkweed is not ready, then they may not lay the eggs, and then may die before laying the eggs. And that would be very dangerous for the population.
Okay, so then describe what happens at that point.
They will lay the eggs in the milkweed, and then the females will die.
So then their children go to where?
Their next generation will emerge, and they will move a little bit to the north, of always looking for the milkweed and following the emergence of the milkweed.
Well, timing and weather are so important to the monarchs. That's part of why they had a good year this last year with up to 600 million. If they leave too early, they could freeze coming back into the U.S., or the milkweed could die, and it would be a wasted migration. The warming climate may cause that problem if they mate and leave too early from Mexico. We're already starting to see a little bit early departure from Mexico this year. And of course, around Labor Day, the butterflies that are here in Minnesota, Canada, other northern states start to make that arduous journey nearly 2,000 miles back to Mexico. That's the incredible migration, and that's the generation that lives for up to 9 months. You can watch all these stories and check out some of the links. Track the butterfly migration this spring by going to carolevin.com/explorewithsven.
Not fascinating. That 2,000 mile journey just blows my mind.
Yeah,
frequent flyer miles there.